Jeremy Sockman here with a review of a movie with more feathered hair and perms than a disco sock hop. This one flew in under the radar years back and you may have missed it, but both me and old Stanley Kubrick himself sure didn't. Heck, that dude just couldn't shut up about how much he loved it. But then he also had a Lolita complex, so maybe we shouldn't be too surprised there. It's Girlfriend from 1978 starring Melanie Mayron, and it certainly left me reeling from the dark truths being exposed. So let's take a look. Girlfriends follows Susan Weinblatt, wedding and bar mitzvah photographer with big dreams. She lives with a writer named Anne, but a wrench is tossed into her single gal world when Anne gets married and moves out. After a one-night stand with Eric, she goes a little loopy and starts to crush on the rabbi. But the kibosh has put her in any stooping when she meets the man's family and gets cold feet.
No.
You keep it that way.
She picks up a hitchhiker named Seal, but the two are a regular odd couple and just can't make it work. Eric comes back into her life and eats her shrimp, so they start up some regular boinking. Then wouldn't you know it, she finally hustles her way into a gallery opening for her pictures. But after a big fight with Anne over babies, marriage, and growing up, her pal won't show up to Susan's big event. Not one to let that slide. Spoiler alert. Susan goes to confront Anne only to take some tequila shots and have a good time.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Duck.
Fuzzy.
Now, Girlfriends may sound like a cute little story of girls that just happen to be friends, but if you're watching this with eyes wide shut, you'll miss all the clues that there's a lot more going on here than you think. You see, this is a movie that doesn't believe girls can be friends. It goes to great lengths to show you over and over again how something always comes between them. Whether it be jealousy over the other's perfect family life, envy over the other's perfect career, one of them ditching the other for a man and a ring, one of them misreading the cues and falling in love with someone who isn't a lesbian, one of them alienating everyone else when a new guy who knows how to work it shows up, or just plain personality clashes, this movie wants you to know that a friendship between two straight gals just isn't in the cards. Even the ending, when you think Susan and Anne have made up over Mexican booze, Anne gets up and leaves the second she hears her husband calling her. Ouch, that's cold, Anne. Now, Girlfriends was written, directed, and produced by women, and pretty much stars all women, so you wouldn't think it would have such a cynical view of straight female relationships. I happen to know a few girls that are friends with each other, so it's not as impossible as Claudia Weill and Vicky Pollan want you to think. So I'm not sure if they just had some bad experiences, or were just real anti-women, but whatever the case, this is one mean-spirited movie and it didn't need an axe-wielding killer or a horrible gang assault to make its point. I'm Jeremy Sockman, and I'm giving the dark and negative look at girl-on-girl friendships that is Girlfriends a hard pass.
I'm very impressed.
Oh, you know.
I'm jealous.
You?
Yes, I am, you squirt.
Julie, listen. She's looking for another photographer. Maybe you should go in and talk to her.
I will.
Okay.
Right now.
Go ahead.
Okay.
Okay.